He has a background as head of marketing at Boa ID. He was head of innovation at the Chaos Piloterne, that we are very proud of, and as startup investor at Accelerace. Currently, he is the CEO and founder of Listen Louder, a company that helps entrepreneurs and companies become more successful and innovative by listening louder. So please welcome award-winning serial entrepreneur, Jonathan Løv. You can do better than that. Come on.
Oh, thank you very much, Paula. Woo! It's just because it's just so awkward to be standing up here, and no, I'm not like Finn Helmer. I didn't sell Giga for $1 billion and so on. So how do you create this sort of placebo effect? I don't know. This was my attempt from a famous television reporter and news host. And now I'm from Jutland, from Aarhus, so we'll bring this right down back to earth. Basically, this is my learnings. Before, there was a sort of a fail-con format where people were talking about their failures and what you learned from them. This is a story, my story, both about success and failure. But not so much my personal story, and then I started this company, then I founded this company. More to get up there in the helicopter and try to look down and look back at what actually happened. Why did I and why do entrepreneurs sometimes succeed? And why do they fail? What do they have in common? What kind of visions do they share? And what kind of methods do they use when they start up a company? And I don't know if you saw the title, but it was Cultural Learnings of America to Benefit the Glorious Nation of Denmark. That's the headline for this keynote speech. And I know it's the longest today. It's inspired by a movie that some of you might have seen with a character called Borat. It's a great inspiration of mine, not so much Borat, but the filmmaker Sacha Baron Cohen. He makes these wonderful movie characters that all share some common traits. They have this vulnerability, they have a sense of humor, and they go out there into the world rather naive and try to get back learnings. Sort of the same way that I've always tried to start up my companies. I've had this dream or inspiration. I've tried, that's why my company is called Listen Louder, to actually, when somebody talks to me, to actually listen in order to hear what they say and not listen in order to come with my words of wisdom. When they need oxygen for their brain, they stop talking, and then I can share my views. Might be kind of different from some entrepreneurs, because we also share this thing that we have rather big egos. I'm one of those, but I've learned to calm it down and say, come on, you're just a guy from Jutland who grew up in a hippie household, and today I'm actually dressed up for the occasion. Normally I'm wearing one of these hoodies. Okay, this one. It's very much like a startup. It's a puzzle. Most startup companies are like this, both when you launch them, and I've tried this 5 times, but also when you go international. As you launch, you're trying to understand what is your product and who are your customers. You basically don't know very much. Like with this one, you have to go guessing. And as the inventor of this one says, if you're curious enough, if you listen loud enough, you'll see that the world always offers you solutions to your questions. Once you start thinking like this, your marketing and your communication and your sales techniques become so much easier because they are authentic. You actually believe what you're saying. You're not trying to make some kind of smart spin.